Start bus admittance matrix. This is a very basic topic of power system analysis. Why basic? Because everywhere we will use bus admittance matrix, whether load flow for Gauss Seidel or Newton Raphson, fast decouple, decouple, etc. etc. So the first one is bus admittance matrix, generally denoted by YBUS. So this matrix contains all information of the connections of the power system. A power system consists of large number of buses. Some buses are having generators connected to them. Some buses are having loads connected to them. Few buses are there where loads as well as generators are connected. Both are connected. So generators, basically power flow is from generators to the system, to the bus. And for load, power flow is from system to the load. Suppose one bus is having both load and generator. So it depends the capacity of alternator and the load. If generator dominates, then net injection of power is there in the system. If load dominates, load is more than the generator capacity connected at a particular bus, it means the net power flow is from system to load. So a power system will have large number of buses, and buses will be interconnected through transmission lines. Clear? So first take a system having few number of buses and lines connecting the buses. So first we will start with four bus system, then we will generalize the concept. So this is one generator connected at a bus, say bus number one. First construct the system of these four buses. So say this bus number one is connected with bus number two, this is bus number three, and this is bus number four. So these are the connections between buses. This is generator. The power, three phase power injected at bus number one is S1. And say this bus is also having load. So represent load by this symbol, and this will be, let us represent generation for G, SG1, and this will be load for SL1. S for apparent power, combination of active and reactive power both. So SG1 is nothing but PG1 plus QG1. Active part of the power generated and injected at bus number 1, and so on for all the buses. So represent here second alternator number 2, and the three phase power flow from alternator to the bus number 2 is SG2, complex power. Say this is also having load, so represent it load. If load is there, then this will have certain values. If not there, so values will be zero. No need to worry, we will consider all possible combinations, right? So for four bus system, the simplest system, first we will assume that all the buses are having alternators and loads. If somewhere the bus is not having any alternator, so the value of S will be zero for that particular bus, and so on, right? So all the cases will be covered by this representation. So this will be SL2, the apparent power of the load connected at bus number 2. Similarly, for the other buses, SL3, and this SG3. SG4, SL4. So in general, SGI is the apparent power flow into the system at ith bus. So I may be for here, I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So that may be written as PEI plus J QGI. Okay? So I may be 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, for load, the total three phase power flowing out of the system, from the system to the load. So SLI may be written as PLI plus J QLI. So the net apparent power flowing into the system at ith bus will be equal to SGI minus SLI. So take I equal to 1. So S1 will be 3 phase apparent power flowing into the system at ith bus. Sorry, I1. So first bus. So this will be SG1 minus SL1. This is flowing into the system. This is flowing out of the system. So net power flow into the system will be difference of these two. If this dominates, then this difference will be positive. So if this is positive, means power flow is
out from
into the system. If this is coming out to be negative, it means this will be negative only when this is greater than this. So load consumption of power is more at that bus than the generation at that bus. It means the net power flow is from system to the load. Clear? So in general, we may write SI is equal to this. Where I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 here, we can generalize up to N. Right? Clear? So it is not always necessary that the connection will be between buses only, consecutive buses only. Sometimes this may be connected with this. This may be connected with this. So later we will discuss on this. How many lines can be formed for a particular set of buses in a power system. So let us connect this also with this. So we may connect this also. So this system is having just 4 buses. When number of buses in the system increases, so such interconnections may also increase, right? Any question till now? Clear? Okay. You might have studied various models of transmission line during your power system 1. Phi model, P model, you have studied that, right? So we will now form the same network. So this is bus number 1 and this is bus number 3. This is bus number 1. Here we have bus number 2. And here we have bus number 4. Make the same connections. Same connections and represent each transmission line with pi model. So you know pi model is having So this is shunt admittance, Y. Y0 you can remember it. So Y0 by 2, say Y0 by 2, like that. In between, impedance is there, so represent it. Resistor, inductor, like that. Right. Similarly, for this system also, represent all the lines, transmission lines with equivalent pi border. So here also, everywhere, similarly for this line, this is basically ground, right? This looks like pi, is not it? So y, half y here, half y here of the line, and impedance is here. Have certain value of resistance of the line and reactance of the line R plus JX. So we will have some impedance. That impedance will be known as, this is bus number 1 and this is bus number 3. So the impedance of the line in between 1 and 3 will be denoted by Z13. Clear? Similarly, this, the impedance of this will be represented by Z12. And reciprocal of Z is admittance. Clear? So Z12 or Y12, where Y12 will be nothing but 1 upon Z12, right? So that is admittance, and we will form one matrix for a particular network that is known as bus admittance matrix. So this is S1 here, you may add this generator. So net flow will be, we have represented by SI. So no need to write generations and load separately. Now we can write directly S1, and we know that S1 is nothing but SG1 minus SL1. So that may be positive or negative. So if generators and loads both are there, then we need to take the difference. In some bus, at some buses only generators will be there, at some buses only loads will be there, at some buses nothing will be there. It is also possible that it is not having either alternator or loads. So we can represent S1.
Then what is the purpose of that bus?
Yeah, later on we will discuss that. Because we are going to discuss the complex interconnection of the whole system, where each and every part, suppose for this India, we are having alternators at several power stations, and all power stations if connected to a particular network, so we need to consider those also, right? So in between, suppose you are going to transmit your power from eastern region to western region, right? So bus, what is the purpose of bus? You are well aware of that. So bus may be required there. So if loads are not there, suppose that location is forest, no population is there, no industry is there. So from where you will get load? And no plant is there. Okay? That is exceptional case. So this will be S3. This will be S2. And this is S4. So the same network is drawn, where each transmission line is represented by the equivalent pi border. Clear? So at bus number 1, see the net admittances, shunt admittances. This one is at bus number 1. This one is also at bus number 1. This one is also at bus number 1. This one is at 2, bus number 2, and this is at bus number 2. This is also grounded, right? So we will take one common reference, ground, at ground potential, right? And you know, addition of admittances parallel. If impedance is there, series connected impedances are added directly, Z1, Z2, Z3, Z0. And what about admittances? Parallel connection, we can add, right? So we can add directly this, plus this, and we can denote it by one single equivalent shunt admittance. Clear? So take this as grounded. This is grounded. And this is bus number 1. So here, generator, this one is connected at bus number 1. Mark it 1. So at bus 1, this plus this, not Y0, something just for representative case, Y by 2. Right. So represent this one as Y10. Y10 is sum of these three Y's. Clear? At 1. This is 2. So make 2 here. And in between, this is 2. So between 1 and 2, what is this? Or admittance. We can say admittance. Y12. Clear? This is Z12. So Y12 will be 1 upon Z12. So we may write here Y12. Again, at bus number 2, sum of these two Y's will give one single Y, reactant Y, that is represented by
Y2.
This is grounded. So this will be Y20. So between 2 and 3, so make somewhere 3 also. Say this is 3. And between these two also, we are having, what will this? This is 3.
Impedance.
So between 2 and 3, we are having Z23 or Y23. Clear? So this will be Y23. Any doubt here? And at 3 also, we are having this, this and this. So we will have single
Y30.
Very good. And then this is 4th one, bus number 4. So make somewhere 4. Let us 4 in here. And in between 3, 4, we have line, right? In between 3, 4, we have line. So we have Z34. So we have Y34. So write this one as Y34. This is 4, bus number 4. And at bus number 4 also, we are having this plus this. Y? Y40. We have one more connection between 1 and 4. Is not it? So we will connect this. This is 1, this is 4. So we will connect this. And this will be Y?
1-4.
We have one more connection between 1 and 3. We have not connected yet. We have not connected 1 and 3. But we are having one transmission line. If it is connected, then we need to represent there, right? So connect this one. Okay, write this 5-3-4 here. And connect this one. So this will be Y 1-3. Okay? Any doubt? So this is equivalent network of the same which we started for a simplest one, 4 bus system. Just we need to depict the connections possible between various buses in a power system. Later on we will generalize the case. So for any number of buses, any number of lines connected in between buses, later on. Till now, no problem, right? So at bus number 1, represent voltage of that bus by V1. V1 is the voltage at bus number 1. Similarly, at bus number 2, voltage is V2 here V3 bus number 3 and V4 at bus number 4. So we are having alternators here also. So let us represent it by I1. I1 is net current flow at bus, this is bus number 2, so this will be I2. This is bus number 1, so represent I1. S1 is net apparent power flowing at bus 1 from the alternator to the system. So we can represent it by I1 also. Net current injection at bus number 1, injection into the system, right? So similarly, I2 at 2, and this is 3, so this will be I3, and this is 4, so this will be I3. Just represent it. If this direction is reversed, it means this bus is load bus. If direction of the current is as it is, then this bus will be generator bus. Okay? So just represent by that. If in calculation this is coming out to be positive, then whatever the assigned directions are assumed, that is correct. Otherwise, reverse of that. Clear? You know KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. So this is one node. So algebraic sum of all currents at this node should be
equal to 0.
Clear? Okay. So I1 is flowing into the system, means incoming current at bus number 1. So we may write, apply KCL at the 4 nodes so far. So we may write, at node 1, I1 will be equal to, so this is Y10. Voltage at this bus is V1. So current will be V1 into Y10. Voltage into admittance gives current. Voltage upon impedance gives current. One upon impedance is nothing but admittance. So you know it, right? So V1, Y10 will be current flowing from this node to this. Because V1 is with respect to ground potential. Is not it? V1 is V1 minus V0. Say V0 is 0 here. So this is at higher potential. V1 is positive. It means current is flowing from this to this. Assume any direction. If your assumption is correct, after calculation, the assumed direction of the current will be positive. Otherwise, negative. No need to worry. Right. So you may write V1 Y10. Clear? So we are going to write algebraic sum of currents. So this current incoming at bus 1 is equal to all outgoing currents. Assume outgoing. If not outgoing, then the direction will be reversed by giving negative sign of the corresponding currents. Right. So what will be current flowing this way from 1 to 2? V1 minus V2 times Y12. Very good. So second will be V1 minus V2 Y12 plus in this branch
V1
minus V3 drop across this. Is not it? V1 minus V3 times V1 minus V3 Y13 plus the last one we have assumed direction. Okay, any direction we can assume. So V1 minus V4 will be the drop across this times V1 minus V4 times
Y14.
Similarly, write KCL equations at other buses, bus number 2, 3, and 4. So I2 will be equal to, quickly tell me. I2 will be equal to incoming at bus number 2. So all outgoing currents. So starting with this branch,
V2 Y20.
First take self one. V2 Y20. So this will be V2 Y20 plus V2 minus V cloud. this will be V2 minus V1. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So you should prove that you are getting. So V2 minus V1 times
Y1.
Plus in this branch V2 minus V2 minus V3
Y2
3 plus one more branch is here. No, no any connection. So no need to write. If line is there, then flow will be there. If no line is there, no flow will be there. Right? Corresponding Y will be 0. Corresponding impedance will be infinity. No connection means impedance is infinite. Current can't flow without line. So impedance will be infinity means Y will be 0. So even if you are writing and putting Y equal to 0 means no line is there, right? Okay. Write about I3. So I3 at bus 3, incoming current at bus 3 can be written as V3
Y3 0
plus, this is the last one. After that we will just form the matrix that has already been formed. Just we will rearrange this and that will be over. Okay, next will be V3 minus V1 Y13 plus 3 is also connected with 2, so this will be V3 minus V2 times Y23. Clear? So this is connected with 4 also plus V3 minus Y34. So there no any other connection is there. We have considered all the connections, right?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All connections we have considered. The last one, I4 will be equal to V4 Y4 0 plus 4 is connected with 1. Start with 1 so that no bus will be missing. Right? Just check whether it is connected with 1, 2, 3, 4. If connected, then right?
Yes.
So start with 1. It will be V1 times Y14 plus. It is not connected with 2. So check at 3. It is connected with 3. So this will be V4 minus V3 times Y34 and that's it. No any other connection? So check connections here. 1, 2, 3. So 3, you have written 1, 2, 3. Right? So the same equation, set of 4 equations corresponding to 4 buses of this network may be written in matrix form as I1, I2, I3, I4, is equal to, so let's start writing. Here, write bus voltages V1, V2, V3, V4. So I1 is V1, Y10, and here also V1 is there. Okay. Here also V1 is there, but all positive, V1, V1, right? So we may write here, Y10 plus Y12, Y13, Y14, all positive, right? Plus Y12 plus Y13 plus Y14, clear? So this will be multiplied with V1, right? The second term will be multiplied with V2. So in this row, for V2, V2 is here only. And this is Y12 negative sign minus Y12. Right here, minus Y12. Next, V3 is here only. See, minus Y13. And V4 is here only. Minus Y?
1, 4.
You can check it. So you need to multiply this row with this column. Is not it? Just take this, multiply this. So this will be multiplied with V1, this with V2, this with V3, this with V4. So you will get this equation. Equation number 1. Clear? So similarly write for other equations. Okay, this is equation number 1, 2, 3, 4. So similarly, for I2, you may write here, V1 is here only, minus Y12. What about this? V2. Y20? Y12? Y23. Take. This is?
Y20.
Y20 plus?
Y12.
Y12 plus? Y23. What about this? V3. Minus Y23. What about that? V3.
Okay.
We have shifted this. Okay, so better shift this here. Minus Y12. So this way we may be assumed below this. Okay. Y20. Y12 and the next was
Y23.
This element is below this element, right? So next one is for 3 minus Y23 and the last one 2, 4, no line, so it will be 0. Okay, write for third one. Quickly. Y30 plus. V3 is with plus. Y30. Okay, first write of diagonal elements. Later on we will write diagonal elements, right? The space required is more here. Just wait for 2-3 minutes. I will complete this. Right. So quickly tell me for I3.
So minus.
Take V1 first. So V1 will be minus Y13, right? Minus Y13. Take for V2. So search for V2. Y23, right? Only here.
Minus
Y23. Search for V3.